That needs to be turned up. Yes, but you know, Hero. It's that time. It's that time, dudes. Finally get to see what Hero is all about. And we get him tomorrow, because Nintendo of Europe decides to pull a stupid. And, yeah.
Hello everyone, I'm Masahiro Sakurai, the director of the Super Smash Bros. Ultimate game from Sora Limited.
I'm not doing that, long time no see. This was like
the
a last second.
The Dragon Quest is joining the battle, and that means I have some new information to share with you. Usually, we prepare a script for Nintendo Direct, and we have editors put various cuts together, but this time, I'd like to take more of a live stream approach and present it myself.
I like that. I like how it's not great.
We don't have much of a budget for this. While I discuss, I'll be playing with the controller as well. I hope you enjoy it.
Yes!
But before we get into it, I should mention that the Dragon Quest series began in 1986. It's an iconic Japanese role-playing game. It wouldn't be an exaggeration to say that Dragon Quest was what popularized RPGs in Japan, and beyond that, it's a top-notch game that's become a cultural phenomenon. The latest entry in the series is Dragon Quest XI S Echoes of an Elusive Age Definitive Edition, which is releasing soon on Nintendo Switch, so please look forward to it. Today, I'll be playing the development version of the ROM, so there may be parts where the camera seems different from the version you have at home. I hope you understand. Here's a lineup of all four heroes. I think, to some, this scene alone might seem pretty astonishing. This one is the hero from Dragon Quest XI S, the one that's releasing soon. The 16-year-old was dubbed the Darkspawn.
I might be using that hero.
A weapon called the Supreme Sword of
11.
Now for the hero from Dragon Quest III. This is the hero Erdrick, and he's 16 years old. He's equipped with Erdrick's sword. Actually, in 3 and 11, the hero's shield designs are almost identical, but we've changed them up a bit. It's all in the details.
It's cool.
Next, the hero from Dragon Quest IV, Chapters of the Chosen. This 17-year-old is the ancestor of the bride from Dragon Quest V, Hand of the Heavenly Bride. He's equipped with the Zenithian Sword. Lastly, the hero from Dragon Quest VIII, Journey of the Cursed King, an 18-year-old who isn't affected by the curse. Munchie is in his pocket, and as a former royal guardsman, he's equipped with the Dragovian King Sword. Munchie. That said, it may be a bit tough to distinguish them using just the name hero, so if you want to refer to each of them individually, here are their names. The hero from 11S is 11, the hero from 3 is Arusu, the hero from 4 is Solo, and the hero from 8 is 8. You can use these names to reference them if you'd like.
You can all call my numbers where they came from, which makes more sense.
The coloring and design of these variations are based on characters from the series. Can you guess who they are?
Nope.
This is actually the very first time that the heroes from the Dragon Quest series have been able to fight each other. It was allowed to finally happen in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, and for that, I am very grateful.
Yes.
Each hero has a different voice actor, and I'd like to introduce them now. Here they are. The hero from 11 is Mitsuki Saiga. This hero speaks in 11S, but the action in this game is different, so her voice acting needed a bit more oomph. The hero from 3 is played by Nobuyuki Hiyama. You might say the King of Braves is playing the hero, but he voiced Link in the original Super Smash Bros. And Super Smash Bros. Melee games,
dude,
so you could say
cool.
He was already a hero.
That's
He's definitely
sick.
A pro, and out of all the voice actors, his recording session went the fastest. The hero from 4 is voiced by Takeshi Kusao. He's a veteran voice actor and asked for a lot of detail on the backstory of his character, and this has carried over into his performance. The hero from 8 is voiced by Yuki Kaji. It was apparently a dream of his to do voice work for the Super Smash Bros. And the Dragon Quest series, so he was happy to have both dreams come true at once.
That's lovely.
The heroes from 3, 4, and 8 are being voiced for the first time in the series, and calling out the spell names is also the series' first.
Yeah, let's learn the moves because that whole...
Now, let's get a look at these fighters in action. The animations are a bit more energetic than the standard sword user, since we aim to match the style of Akira Toriyama.
You can lock with that? Hello? That's down smash.
Sometimes the hero's smash attack results in a critical hit. It happens at random, but when it does, you'll perform
it. It happens at random. Dude, that's messed up!
These
that's gonna be
hits
so
actually
fucked
match
up.
The look of critical hits in various installments of the series. Note the subtle nuances.
The that went from 1854!
Various projectiles. His forward tilt is a shield bash attack that can also be used to block projectiles.
Dude, that's cool!
His neutral special is the Frizz family of spells. Frizz.
Frizz.
Frizzle.
Frizzle.
And Kafrizz.
Alright, so it has three levels.
You can stop your charge in the middle by shielding, and then you can resume charging again. Then,
okay.
You could store the full charge until you're ready to unleash it at any time.
That's I like that. That's
however, even if you've charged up a Kafrizz, nothing will happen if you don't have enough MP at
the okay, the mana refills! Careful. That's cool!
Hero's side special produces zap-type spells. Enter the command quickly for a zap, which is a good way to keep opponents in check. Hold it down a little longer for a Zapple, which has a pretty good reach. And if you charge it up all the way,
Kazap.
You'll let loose a Kazap. Each of these spells imbues your sword with lightning to power up your attacks. Next is the Whoosh family of spells, which can be used for recovery. Performing a short up special results in a Whoosh. Charging it a little bit results in a Swoosh. And charging
swoosh.
It up all the way results in a Kaswoosh.
A Kaswoosh.
You can only store a charge with Frizz-type spells. A Whoosh is fairly stunted, requiring only a little MP. A Swoosh actually provides a bit more lateral movement. A Kaswoosh allows you to recover even if you fall pretty far.
Okay, that's cool. I like it.
Also, Whoosh-type spells can blow enemies.
Can he act out of it? Ooh, that's gonna be meta changing.
That way you can interfere with opponents. Next is Hero's down special, command selection.
Okay, here's the good part.
His down special pulls up a random list of commands.
I can't read that.
Doing so allows you to use a spell or other move. Oomph simply raises your attack power. With a fully charged smash attack.
That shit's gonna
can
be
deal
disgusting.
This much damage. Now for Psycho. It increases the power of your next attack. The difference between this one and Oomph is that it can only be used once, but the effect lasts until your attack finishes, even if you miss. Next up, Bounce.
Yep, here comes the reflector.
It reflects your opponent's spells and other projectiles. If you both cast Bounce, this will happen. The effect of the reflect will be exponential.
That Sori is just like the fucking reflectors for every other character.
Heal lets you reduce your damage percentage. Flame Slash can spread damage to a wide area in front of you. Crackle Slash can freeze opponents. Accelerator significantly increases your speed.
Is he legit just Shulk? Oh my god, it's just Shulk and Link.
Kaboom sets off a mighty explosive spell.
Yo, that looks cool.
Snooze puts opponents to sleep. That way, you can follow it up with a beefy attack. Maybe something like Hatchet Man. And then there's Thwack. This fearsome spell could potentially KO an opponent in one hit. However, the opponent's damage percentage will ultimately determine the effect. So if their damage percentage is low, it's less likely to activate.
And but it still kills!
This spell is well suited for recovery. As demonstrated, it lets you recover from anywhere, but you may hit your head on the ceiling.
Dude, that's
Ka-clank. When you cast the spell, you become impervious to attacks. But watch out for a Metal Slash. Metal Slash is a skill that can KO a metal opponent in one hit. Hocus Pocus is a spell with unpredictable effects. Oh, looks like it slowed me down. But not all of its effects are bad. Sometimes good things happen too.
Are you serious?
Magic Burst. As you can see, my MP is depleting rapidly because the spell uses all your remaining MP to deal massive damage.
That looks so cool!
The amount of MP you have will determine how effective it is. And finally, Kamikaze. This spell produces an extremely powerful explosion, but this also results in self-destruction. He has many different special moves. In fact, of all the fighters, Hero has the highest number of them in the game.
That's why did it do that much?
Command selection before choosing a spell by pressing the R button. That way, you can try again and hope for a different set of spells.
Okay, that's actually cool.
That's his final smash, Giga Slash, and it's no mere Kazakh. This move calls upon all the past protagonists to lend the hero their power for one mighty blow.
They should have went the one with the blue hair and the one, like, the blue kind of Saiyan hair.
This attack has a high vertical range, and if it's within 4 in-game meters, it will connect.
Why is that so large?
The command selection move is unlike any other in the game. It may be a bit hard to imagine how it works, so I'll fight a CPU opponent for a while.
You better get someone from that back camera, Sakurai. Beat the crap out of him. There's the new stage.
I'm fighting at Yggdrasil's altar. I'm the hero from 8, and the CPU is the hero from 4. The stage starts off on this platform, which begins to rise. You can use Frizz to keep opponents in check without charging. I'll use Zappo from a distance.
This honestly looks cool.
Pretty good.
Look how beautiful that is!
Try command selection. Snooze.
Yo!
Good stuff.
Good stuff.
Kaboom. I am a little low on MP, so I'm going to attack to refill it. But meanwhile,
oh, so you attack to refill? Okay.
Meter.
I thought it was gonna be like a one stock only thing.
Not going to let him.
And there goes his down air. Yeah. Right in the butt.
Critical hit.
So it's a critical hit from anywhere?
Heal.
That's disgusting.
I'll go ahead and use Accelerator. And the final smash. Hope I can finish him off.
That voice acted.
Oops, I used Hatchet Man. But ended up blocking a projectile with it. Oh. Platform. Is he going to do it? Ooh, he got me.
Oof.
I was trying to counterattack with his Crackle Slash, but he got me. And at the edge of the screen, no less.
It's a whale.
In these free-for-all battles, it's pretty... Oh, time's up.
Let's see the victory screen. That's sick.
This stage is called Yggdrasil's Altar, and it's based on a location in Dragon Quest XI-S. One difference is that the platform rises, which is very Super Smash Brothers.
Yep.
Look at that. We're passing close by Cetacea. After that, we'll be able to see all of Erdrea.
Yo!
The giant tree in the background is an important point in Dragon Quest XI-S. You can see a Tackle walking by. While the Tackle is out there, some sort of platform will appear. We just passed Arboria, and you can see what looks like a rainbow bridge. And now we pass Havens Above.
Okay. Somebody fucking clip that one.
You'll see slimes appear in the background. But
slime.
You'll see liquid metal slimes appear too. Those are really rare.
Dude, that's gonna be fun.
As we pass Cetacea again, we draw near to the giant tree. As we make our way up the tree,
it's so cool!
We can see a light, which also appears in Dragon Quest XI-S.
That's so beautiful, I love it.
And then we finally make our way back around. By the way, there's something over here. Sometimes a treasure chest appears at this stage, as you can see here. If you open it, you get an item. But it could also be a trap.
Ah, traps.
Ouch.
Whoa!
It's a mimic. If you try your hardest, you might defeat it. You don't have to fight it, but if you manage to beat it... you'll get an item.
Just a freaking...
Although Yggdrasil's Altar is based on the world of 11S, I felt it would be unfortunate to have only one or two songs from that game.
Yeah!
So instead,
remember Cloud?
To compile a collection of field and battle tunes for each hero. Here's what it looks like. Players who have an emotional attachment to specific music tracks can use the My Music feature to pick their favorite ones to play. Of course, you can also enjoy them by using the Sound Test feature. You won't be able to select the famous prelude that way, but the end of the prelude will play during the hero's victory screen.
That's cool, I like that.
We've also added other content, including something for the Spirit Board, so please look out for that as well. Hero will be available on Tuesday, July 30th.
Wait, what?!
If you have the Fighter's Pass, you should be able to get him right away.
Is that today?!
We're also planning to make him available individually for $5.99.
I thought Nintendo Europe leaked that shit tomorrow!
We're also
what?!
Adding in new Mii Fighter costumes. Please take a look.
I mean, if it's not today, then, you know, whatever. It's fine. But if it's today, holy fucking shit! Yes! Did I not kind of jump on out? Nope. Okay, I'm good. So we get Mii costumes from 11. From Veronica, yeah. Whoa. Oh, never mind. That's just a sword fight. Dragon Quest. First one. Yeah, it's the first one that Erdrick from the first Dragon Quest. Makes sense. Is this Dragon Ball? Hello? Is this like an Akira Toriyama kind of thing? Cause that's cool. It's like an outfit that Yamcha team would wear. Dude, I can't wait. At least they kept their promise of releasing in July. I thought it was gonna release in August. See, look, July 30th! That's fucking today! Oh my god!
Along with Hero, the version 4.0 update will also be available.
New Final Smash Meter time limit.
There will now be a time limit on the Final Smash Meter. That'll make it harder to use your attack range to play a waiting game. So I think it's better to just use your Final Smash when it's ready. It will stick around for a while, and you'll be able to tell how long you have by looking at the meter.
Finally, Final Smash Meter nerf. A new adventure mode.
We're also adding a very easy difficulty to adventure mode. So if a battle is just too difficult for you to clear, or if you simply want to have a relaxing time playing,
you mean pussy mode, Sakurai? A spectate what?
Another new feature will let you
finally
pick the winner during spectate mode.
Then they brought back the betting
for an item.
They brought back freaking betting from Smash 4.
So suggest supporting fighters to your heart's content.
It's freaking awesome. Online tourney mode. Woo!
Online tourney mode will also be added in.
Fuck yeah! That'll be cool.
In-game tourney, all you have to do is select the mode. The rules are preset, but they'll change periodically. I hope you enter these tourneys over and over.
Dude, they brought it back!
We also plan to hold special event tourneys from time to time.
Dude, they brought it fucking back!
What's more,
I gotta see like over 60 heroes.
Being able to insert screenshots into the videos you edit, and being able to consecutively play videos that have been added to shared content. Plus, there are new amiibo available now. Isabelle,
Sakurai,
Pokemon Trainer,
and Pichu!
Each one will be available in a yellowish package, so keep an eye out for them.
Dude, I wanna get Pokemon Trainer Isabelle.
Finally, the fighter known as Hero will be distributed soon, but Dragon Quest XI S Echoes of an Elusive Age Definitive Edition.
September 27th. I actually might get that.
So please check that out as well.
I'm actually playing Dragon Quest.
We tried a live stream like format this time, but I'm
playing
still
Dragon
not
Quest
sure
3
if we
at the
will
moment.
Do this every time a new fighter is released. Regardless, I hope you have fun with Hero.
Thank you, Sakurai.
See you next time.
Bye. Is that it? That's it. Woo! Hell yeah! Fuck yeah, let's go, dude! Hero, online tourney mode, the spectating mode for fucking Smash 4 is back! Oh my god, let's go. Let's fucking go.